gentlemen, please remain standing while alumna Pratiti Mehta from the Paul Mirage School of Business, class of 2016, sings our national anthem.
Twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, were so gallantly streaming.
Wow, wow. Thank you, Pratiti. That was magnificent. Ladies and gentlemen, please be seated. So good morning, and what a good morning it is. I am Chancellor Howard Gilman, and on behalf of the faculty and staff of the Paul Mirage School of Business at the University of California, Irvine, welcome to the 2017 commencement ceremony. I would like to acknowledge first our ceremony's Mace Marshal, distinguished alumnus Mark Kiki. Mark, could you rise for a second? Mark is a double UCI alumnus, earning his undergraduate degree in 1983 and earning his MBA with the Mirage School class of 1993. Can we recognize Mark for his tremendous work as Mace Marshal? And remain standing. Also joining me on the platform are the following chief academic and administrative officers of the university and other participants in the ceremony. When I call your name, I'd like you to stand and remain standing. Audience, please hold your applause until everyone's been recognized, and then we'll recognize everyone as a group. First is Vice Chancellor for University Advancement, Brian Hervey, and from the Paul Mirage School of Business, Eric Spangenberg, Dean, Andy Policano, former dean and current Dean's Leadership Circle Endowed Professor. Terry Shevlin, Associate Dean of Research and Doctoral Programs. Mary Gilley, Senior Associate Dean. Gerardo Oquizen, Associate Dean of Master's Programs. Patricia Wellmeyer, Faculty Director of the Master's of Professional Accountancy Program. And V.C. Chowdhury, Associate Dean of Undergraduate Programs. I would also wish to acknowledge the presence on the platform of distinguished faculty from the Paul Mirage School of Business. Faculty, will you also rise? And please let me also acknowledge senior staff members from the master's and undergraduate programs here to witness today's ceremony. Will they please rise as well? So ladies and gentlemen, please acknowledge our platform party. Good job, everyone. Good job. Okay, now you can sit down. Today, the Paul Merage School of Business is recognizing 551 graduates, including 8 new doctors of philosophy, 273 masters of business administration, 108 masters of professional accountancy, and 162 bachelors of arts in business administration. And of course, let me begin this joyous ceremony by offering congratulations, of course, to the graduates who have worked so hard to reach this day, to the faculty who have instructed and mentored them, the families, friends, and loved ones who have nurtured them and guided them. This is truly a day to celebrate. And on behalf of all of us, the entire faculty of the University of California, Irvine, let me say to you, to everyone in the class of 2017, that you have also enriched us immeasurably, and we are grateful for having had the honor of having you as our students. And so thank you for that, but most importantly, let me then say for the first time where everyone can join in, the first time of something we're going to say over and over again, let's hear it for the class of 2017. Go Eaters. All right. It's now my pleasure to introduce the fearless leader of the Paul Merage School of Business. Let's hear it for Dean Eric Spangenberg.
All right. Thank you, Chancellor Gilman. And you know what? I saw a lot of you taking selfies on your way in. And, right? It's what we do now, right? And so what I'm going to ask you to do is I'm going to ask you to promise that you'll take a selfie on the way out, because I'm pretty sure you're going to be 1 degree hotter. Get that? See what I did there? It's a good-looking group already, but you're going to be a hotter-looking group about an hour and a half from now. Yeah, okay. That was a little bit of polite applause. I'll see if I can do better. All right. Okay, you know, I look around, though, and I see that you are really one of the major reasons why the Paul Merage School is as great as it is. You know, we continue to ascend in global reputation. We're on the front page of all the major rankings in the world. You know, and so it's you, the students, that really help to make a big difference in that regard. It also helps that we have great faculty. It also helps that we have great staff. We have a great central administration that supports our initiatives. You know, we all are working hard to uphold our standards with regard to teaching and research. And, you know, it's just the audience here. We've got audience members, and our guest speaker today are members of the business community that provide jobs. They provide their time, their talent, and their treasure to ensure that we're actually contemporized and that we're doing the best we can for them, and they're doing the best they can for us. And so we're pretty excited about that, to provide you with the opportunity to celebrate with this kind of a group. The family members that are here too are pretty important, right? Because they provided the support for you to achieve what you did today. You didn't get here by accident, right? Somebody once told me that you don't see a turtle on a fence post that got there alone, right? So so that was just another try, and it didn't go too far. All right, whew, okay. Tough crowd. But, you know, you really are world-class graduates, because we can kind of teach you a lot of things about optimizing systems and so forth, and differentiation and all that kind of stuff, but you've got to have the right inputs to any system to be able to actually have the right kind of outputs. And so it was the selection of you, whether it was a year ago, 2 years ago, 4 years ago, that actually really made the difference of who you are today. And so we're really proud of you, and you are among the best of the best. And whatever your stage in life, whether it's undergraduate, one of the master's programs, PhD program, a specialized master's program, MBA, now is the time that when you might think you're done, you're really kind of just getting started with something new, right? And that's part of our plan. We want you to learn how to learn better, to continue to learn throughout life. And the Merage School is working hard to help make that possible. And I trust that you will leave here not just with a piece of paper that opens doors, but with a set of tools that will help you to deliver value once those doors are open. And then if you realize you need something else, you'll figure it out. You've learned how to learn a little bit better. So this perspective you've gained through the innovation and collaboration and growth of your time here in the Merage School sets you forth on a different kind of a journey, a new stage in your life. And I gotta be honest, I'm a little bit envious because I look and I go, God, I remember that. And it wasn't that long ago, but it was 35 years ago, or it was 30 years ago. And I'm like, I'm jealous, but I'm just telling you, just claim the time, okay? And it's a great place to be. I'm happy I get to stay in the Merage School, and I hope you guys will come back and visit us all in the Merage School. We have a really well-deserved reputation of being a personal school where, as I'd mentioned, the inputs are important. We do a lot of work to make sure the right people come in to study with us. And then once you're here, you develop a lot of personal relationships with one another while you're here. And in that vein, I want to give one piece of advice. I kind of get on this kick of this kind of advice, but I'd like you to stay in touch with one another. This is the piece of advice. The relationships that you've developed are as important, if not more important, than a lot of the things you learned in the classroom or in your projects and so forth. And so reach out and get in touch with the people. Don't say goodbye, let's get together, and then not get together. You know, make sure that you're spending the extra effort to get together, and do it in person. And what I mean by that is a lot of times, I mean, just like you were taking selfies, a lot of us do a lot of texting. But what's the difference? There's a big difference between texting somebody LOL and actually laughing out loud with that person, right? Or there's a big difference between, saying, I'm going to send a little crying emoticon, or actually putting your arm around somebody when they're crying, or having somebody put their arm around you when they're crying. So don't lose the human touch, right? That time you spent together, you might not have as much time, but try and figure out how to set aside time. If we simply slip into accepting or preferring these diminished substitutes for relationships and communication, I think we become diminished substitutes of humanity. So just say hi to people and look up from your phone once in a while as you're walking, right? And look people in the eye and give them the time and give them the talent and the treasure that you'd like them to give you. So that's all I'm going to say. It's part of being human, and I don't want you to lose that as you walk out the door into your new career opportunities and so forth. So it might sound self-serving for me to ask you to come back and visit us, but it is in a way, because what it is it's helping us to serve the next generation of students in whatever your respective programs are, or some other program that you might not have participated in, but now you have a need to hire an accountant, or now you have a need to hire an undergraduate student who's coming out and can help you in your systems optimization or whatever it might be. So go ahead and take the phone calls from the students, become a mentor as opposed to a mentee, and I promise you won't regret doing so. So now I would like to introduce our distinguished commencement speaker, and it's a man whose name is well known for his work and his philanthropic service here in Orange County and beyond, and his company is well known throughout the world, and I would warrant many of you have one of his products, at least one of his products, maybe more. I'm talking about William Wang, founder and chairman of Vizio, and he's also the CEO of Vizio Incorporated. And William moved from Taipei at age 12 with his family to Hawaii, where his parents believed they could find a better opportunity for education for him. And then a couple of years later, they moved to Southern California, and it was there that William, I'm told, began his love of American TV. And it's kind of funny that somebody would say that my love for American TV led to my success, right? But you never want to eliminate alternatives, right? William attended college at USC, graduated in 86 with a Bachelor of Science in Electrical Engineering. After graduation, he joined a rapidly growing computer monitor company, quickly rose to the head of marketing and sales, and then left to launch MAG Innovation and later Princeton Graphics Systems. These companies became successful by introducing some of the first in CRT technology and later LCD technology. And if you stop and think about that, these are things that we sort of take for granted today, but if you live through this period of time, this is one of the people right here who actually was the brains behind the operation and making these things happen, and we're pretty grateful for that. With the U.S. government's mandate to convert to digital TV, some of you might remember that, I know I do, as well, and I was skeptical, like, oh, that'll never happen, right? Okay, but he had the technical know-how behind making HDTV, and William saw enormous potential, and so he said, I'm gonna design and deliver a superior TV to a mass market audience. So in 2002, William launched Vizio with the mission to make expensive plasma and LCD technology affordable yet maintain high quality. And by forming close partnerships with retailers, component suppliers, and ODMs, along with the creating industry-leading operational efficiencies, William brought Vizio's products to Costco shelves by the second quarter of 2003. Think about how quick that is. In 2002, he launched, 2003, they're there, and we're buying them, right? 4 years later, millions of Americans owned Vizio TVs, and by 2007, Vizio became one of the leading HD TV brands in America. His personal accolades include Entrepreneur of the Year from Ernst & Young, Chapman University, Orange County Business Journal, and the Chinese American Academic and Professional Society Model Entrepreneur Award, and he's a Forbes 25 Most Notable Chinese American. In addition to many charities that Williams regularly supports, he serves on the boards of the Segerstrom Center for the Arts and the Tim Salmon Foundation, and is a vice chair of the American Film Institute Corporate Council. So with that, I would like to ask you to please join me in welcoming William Wang.
Thank you, Dean. Well, good morning, class of 2017, and congratulations to your outstanding achievement. You made it. For some of you, this is your first college degree. Well, welcome. Welcome to the club. I got a bachelor too. I don't have a lot of color also on my shirt. But for most of you here today, you're earning your master's or PhDs. Well, I envy you. I know for a fact that my beautiful tiger mom, who's here today, still wishes I was more educated like you. So I'll trade seat with you was my private plane. But I don't have a private plane. Vizio is very good in value, so I can't afford a private plane. So you're all here today because you accomplished something great. Through blood, sweat, tears, and probably a lot of coffee. You made it to this moment. But if I ask you what single trait got you here, what would you say? Hard work? Dedication? Dumb luck? I say it's because you have a lot of courage. This is how I got to where I am today. Courage. We all had the same fears. The fear of being a loser, the fear of rejection, the fear of uncertainty. But we also had the fear, or we also have the courage to face those fears and to not give up. Let me tell you a couple of stories about being a loser. The first one starts in 1976. I was 12 years old when my family first moved to Hawaii from Taiwan. We moved for a better life and education. It was everything a boy could want. Sunshine, beaches, Mai Tais, and of course, bikinis. But I hated it. I wanted to go back to Taiwan. I didn't know the culture here. I didn't speak a word of English. I didn't have a single friend. In Taiwan, I was a very popular kid. top of my class. In Hawaii, I was a nobody, with no friends and terrible grades. Basically, I was a loser. One time during lunch at school, away from the crowd, I was sitting by myself under the coconut tree. Suddenly, this tough kid comes out to me and started yelling at me. I didn't understand English, and I had no idea what the hell he was saying. Maybe I took his favorite lunch spot, or maybe he was talking crap about my mom. All I knew was that he was pissed. And the more I stared at him, the angrier he got, until finally he stopped talking and started punching. See, I was just a skinny little Asian Forrest Gump with a report card full of Fs, getting beat up by this 6 foot tall kid with an aloha shirt. Okay, maybe I'm exaggerating a little bit. I was never skinny. But the point is, I was always afraid of being a loser. And suddenly, I was the definition of one. But instead of feeling sorry for myself and blaming others for my misery, I made an effort to learn English and adopt America as my country. Today, I'm living the American dream. Where else can you build a multi-billion dollar company with only $600,000? Now, my second story about being a loser is a lesson no business school would ever teach you. How to lose a lot of money by being an arrogant jackass. I started my first company when I was 26 years old, and quickly, I made my first $1 million before I turned 30. And with the early success, I became, obviously, pretty arrogant. Then, I lost my first $40 million before I turned 40. Mostly due to my obsessive micromanagement style. How's that for a loser? But if I hadn't given up back then, I would have wasted my $40 million worth of tuition. So I didn't give up. Win or lose, I always keep going and never stop fighting back. Of course, being a loser wasn't the only thing I was afraid of. I'm also damn afraid of rejection. I got rejected a lot in school and as an entrepreneur. And no, I don't mean just by girls. After Edison High School, I got into USC Engineering School. Okay, we'll leave the children out today. As a freshman, I failed my very first electrical engineer class. Little did I know, that was only the first of many Fs to follow. To be honest, I only ever got one high score my entire college career, and that was in Robotron, a state-of-the-art video game in the USC arcade. I spent more time in the basement of the arcade playing Robotron than drinking, partying, going to classes, or study. A quarter would last me all day on that very same game. Sorry, Mom, I know I miss a lot of classes, and those classes are pretty expensive, but my entertainment expense was pretty low. A quarter would last me all day. Was it worth it? Well, I mean, I was the undefeated champion of Robotron. My name was on the first, second, third, and fourth places. But I was pretty damn good. Unfortunately, graduate school did not look at my Robotron score. They looked at my GPA, I saw 2.3. So while all my classmates were moving on to get their master's and PhD, my application was rejected by almost every grad school, including USC and UC Irvine. Sorry. Maybe I can keep the cap. Guess what, though? Years later, USC invited me back to give a commencement speech to the engineering grad school. I also received the Outstanding Alumni Award and Global Leadership Award. Not so bad for USC or UC Irvine reject. So I'm doing this. Let me give you an example. Oh, no, I'm sorry. Skip, jump ahead. And if it wasn't for them, or UC Irvine rejecting me, I wouldn't be walking the path I'm on right now. In fact, if it wasn't for all the rejection that followed even after college, I wouldn't be standing here. Let me give you an example. Sometime after starting Visio, I traveled all the way to a city nearby Osaka. I post on strings and had an appointment with a junior manager of the Panasonic Plasma Panel Factory. Plasma was a big deal at the time. Top-of-the-line display technology, great picture, high demand, very expensive, over $10,000. I was so excited, I knew my ideas were blown away. When I got there, they told me to please wait in the lobby. So I waited and waited and waited. When lunchtime came, everybody left the building and the lights turned off. But I decided to wait in the dark. And ended up waiting over 5 hours until finally the manager came out and asked him to please sell me 1,000 plasma panels so I could build my TVs. I was hungry, tired, jet lagged, but I still pushed my big idea to him with real excitement because I believe in it so much. My big idea was that I can build a plasma TV by using their component and sell it at 30% of the cost, 30% of the retail price at Costco. The conversation was short, and I was immediately left out of the room. 5 hours of waiting and less than 20 minutes of talking. It was clear the manager thought I was a moron, because in his mind, only a moron would think I had a chance against the billion-dollar consumer electronic companies like Sony, Samsung, Panasonic, or Toshiba. But you know, he was probably 99% right. As you can imagine, that was a low point for me. To be so passionate about my ideas, to be so determined to make it happen, only to be rejected once more. But this is what I mean, confronting the things you're afraid of the most is going to be hard. And losing from time to time is going to be even harder. Fear might push you to your limits, but you can determine whether it's going to push you forward or backward. So another handful of years passed. Visio became number one in America, and Panasonic was in deep trouble. And you know why they were in trouble? Because of me. With that one person a chance, we became pretty successful. We pushed consumer to LCD instead of plasma. Because Panasonic made me wait during lunch and I got hungry. The moral of the story is, don't make me hungry. You won't like me when I'm hungry. And the Panasonic CEO learned this the hard way. He invited me back and drew out the red carpet. They served me the best sake they had. and they treated me to a magnificent feast. During the dinner, they asked me to buy a plasma panel from them to save their ass. After careful consideration, I politely rejected them, and their multi-billion-dollar factory shut down soon after. As you can see, I've been through the highs and the lows and everything in between. I was a loser and a reject. I have been rich and I have been poor. I have been humiliated and I've been honored, sometimes by the very same people. Today I might be successful, tomorrow I might fail. This brings me to what I believe is the most difficult fear to face, the fear of uncertainty. This will be my final story. One stormy evening, I was sitting in an airplane along with 178 other passengers. I was on the way home after begging one of my creditors to give me more time to pay off my debts. This was after I lost $40 million. Of course, I was under a lot of stress at that time, but I was also so excited to get home. It was Halloween, and I really wanted to take my daughter off a trick-or-treat for the first time. Then the plane crashed. I don't mean severe turbulence or a bumpy takeoff. I mean a Boeing 747-400 crashed into a bunch of construction equipment at over 160 miles per hour. In seconds, the plane was torn apart and then exploded. I won't go into the detail of the damage, but 83 of the 179 occupants died on impact. Immediately after the impact, I was uncertain whether I'm going to live or die. And after the fire, smoke started to fill the cabin, and I was uncertain whether I would ever breathe again. I ran to the nearest exit. Of course, with my lock that day, the first door I tried was locked and won't open. So I ran to the next nearest exit. That door won't open either. Well, you know what they say. When one door shuts, another one opens. And when that door doesn't open, you keep kicking it until it does. Like I keep on saying, be courageous and don't give up. That's what I did, and it saved my life. Along with 8 other passengers and crew members who followed me out on the very same door. In the end, the creditors I met was felt so bad for me that they not only gave me more time to pay, but they became my shareholder. And 2 years later, I saw the Vizio. I'm not saying that getting into a life-threatening plane crash was a good thing, but I guess my situation would have been a lot worse. But this is what I'm talking about. The fear of uncertainty. Not just being uncertain of whether you're going to pass this class, get that job, achieve some level of success, or make or lose millions of dollars. Uncertainty also means not knowing whether you're going to die today or tomorrow or 60 years from now. It's not knowing if the door is locked or open. And also not knowing if you get to spend another holiday with your family. But if you let that fear consume you, and if you let it prevent you from trying new things and taking a bigger risk, then the door in front of you will always be closed. So I guess what am I trying to say is that in all my years of experience, through my trial and error, I found that what really made me the person I am today is not because I work harder than anybody else, or that I was smarter or even more dedicated than anyone else. I simply had the courage to face my fears. And when I lost against them, I will pick myself back up and try it again and again and again. You're all here today because you face your fears and won. That means that no matter what, you will have the courage to do so again. You're all stronger than you think. You can handle loss, you can handle rejection, and you can handle uncertainty. If you take anything away from today, besides my charming personality and my lame jokes, it should be that having fear will never stop you from reaching your full potential. But lacking the courage to face it well, don't remain sheltered and allow fear to get the best of you. And when it feels like the whole world is against you, just remember me. This once skinny Asian Forrest Gump with a bloody nose underneath the coconut tree. The nerd hiding in the school arcade. The reject from UCI and USC. The starving dreamer on a train in Japan. And the father who missed his daughter's first trick-or-treat. Actually, on second thought, one more critical takeaway, just one more. Don't forget, and don't ever forget, when you're so successful with millions of dollars, with a great job and a great family, you got to buy Vizio TV the rest of your life. So for your courage and your success, I want to congratulate you once more and thank you for allowing me to join you for a celebration today. Thank you.
Thank you very much, William. That was a unique and inspiring story, and I know that it will help inspire our graduates to create their own unique stories of success and failure and success again. So we want to end on the upside of things. Thank you very much. I'm now pleased to introduce our first student speaker, undergraduate Arden Davis. She auditioned among students across nearly all of our academic programs and today represents the undergraduate class of 2017. The judging was based on a number of factors, and Arden, like all the applicants, is a shining example of the student population that we're really proud to have here in the Merage School. Arden is a business administration major with an emphasis in marketing, but those studies haven't stopped her from participating in a lot of other things at UCI and beyond. For the past 4 years, she's been the libero for the volleyball team, has also been the captain for the last two, and named Big West Scholar Athlete of the Year for 2016. Arden's also a member of Delta Gamma, where she served as Director of Financial Obligations and was named the Greek Outstanding Sophomore of the Year in 2015. She's volunteered her time with CHOC for the annual toy drive with the UCI Police Department and with the Blind Children's Learning Center in Santa Ana. And for the past 2.5 years, Arden has worked for the Irvine Company as the UCI Campus Brand Ambassador, a Talent Acquisition Associate, and as a Corporate Finance Associate. So what did you do in your spare time? That's what I'm wondering, right? Following graduation, Arden will kick off her career in commercial real estate with CBRE in their Newport Beach headquarters. So join me in welcoming Arden.
I would like to start off by saying congratulations to the UCI Paul Merage School of Business, class of 2017. Thank you to all of the faculty, staff, professors, family, and friends that are here today, and for all of your support in helping us get to this point in our lives. We should be proud to be graduating with such valued degrees, but we also need to remember to be appreciative of how we got here. Something I love about UCI is that it brings such a diverse group of people together into one community. Now, many other schools do this as well, but what I think UCI does best is that it brings unity out of this diversity. When we all stepped onto this campus for the first time, we came equipped with very different backgrounds, experiences, languages, and knowledge. What UCI did from there was help us learn lessons we had not learned yet and could not have learned anywhere else. It taught us the simple things, like how we shouldn't wash our whites with our colors. Going back for that extra cookie in Commons or Pippins will surely lead to the freshman 15. We learned what an anteater is and what sound they make, zot zot, who knew? And we most definitely learned that $1 boba only exists on Ring Road. Now, while that is great, let's get serious about what UCI really taught us. UCI taught us how to be forward thinkers, innovators, and entrepreneurs that can analyze problems and provide answers to the questions society doesn't even know they have yet. It taught us how to lead, be confident, and not be afraid to think outside of the box. It taught us how to not see barriers within diverse cultures, but instead to see the beauty and power of them. And whether we know it or not, UCI has taught us that we're ready to close this chapter of our lives and take on the new ones. I hate to break it to you, graduates, but when we take on our first or our next jobs, there isn't going to be a syllabus waiting for us at our desk telling us exactly what to expect, how to do each individual task, and it most definitely won't say that our work is going to be evaluated on a curve. But we need not to worry. UCI and the Paul Mirage School of Business have prepared us with intelligence, grit, and poise that we will carry with us far beyond the reception of these diplomas and enabling us to conquer anything thrown our way. Now, some of us have the next 10 to 15 years of our lives planned out. And then some of us haven't planned past where we're going to brunch after this ceremony. But whichever category you fall into, just remember that no matter where we are at in our lives, we will always have the support of the anteater family that UCI has provided for us. And that's saying a lot, because even though anteaters aren't very big, I'd say they're pretty strong. UCI has made a huge impact on all of our lives, and now it is our turn to set out to make this same impact on the lives of many others. Thank you, and congrats again to the class of 2017.
Well, thank you, Arden. I know I join everyone here in wishing you the best professionally and personally moving forward. I'm now pleased to introduce our second student speaker, Shannon Shetty from the Raj School's fully employed MBA program. She's here today to represent the graduate class of 2017. Shannon is a Southern California native and graduated from UC Irvine in 2010 with a degree in business economics and a minor in management. Soon after graduation, Shannon was responsible for account management at a shipping and logistics company and then managed business operations in an engineering firm until she realized that she was most passionate about the healthcare industry and she decided to come back and pursue her MBA. During her time in the FEMBA program at the Merage School, Shannon served as a section representative for her class while working full-time at Anthem Blue Cross, where she's currently part of the labor and trust account management team. She also is active in various organizations on campus, including the Challenge for Charity and the Merage Healthcare Association. She's an avid traveler with a passion to learn and experience different cultures, and one of her most memorable trips was earlier this year when she was able to go with the Merage School to Cuba, and she was able there with her classmates to collaborate with students from the University of Havana in a unique way to address business challenges in Cuba. She notes she was delighted to broaden her perspective on the economic, government, business, and social transformation of the country during that trip. I'm going to now turn it over to Shannon. Welcome her.
Every day, chip away. My grandmother always told me, every day, chip away. Work hard, and even a small step forward is better than standing still. But today, we are taking a big step forward, graduating from one of the top 50 business schools in the country, so this is our moment to let it sink in. Family, friends, faculty, and fellow graduates, good morning. I am deeply honored to be standing here in front of all of you today to address our graduating class. Walking next to you all fills me with great pride, happiness, but most of all, gratitude. None of us made it here on our own. In 1971, my grandmother came to this country by herself with nothing more than a dream and the belief that hard work pays off. She started out selling Avon door to door, and eventually, the culmination of many, many small steps enabled her to bring the rest of her family to the United States, every day chipping away. With each generation, my family takes another step forward, and this MBA was just as much my grandmother's dream as it was mine. I am now the first in our family with a graduate degree, so thank you, Grams, for always believing in me. We all have our own stories of how we got here. We come from different backgrounds, yet we sit here today as one family. Our graduating students, as well as alumni, represent a wide variety of industries and Fortune 500 companies. Some here today have even started their own companies. Every graduate brings something so unique to this program, which ultimately shapes a diverse and transformative community. That is what is unique about UCI. From my time here as an undergraduate to today, over a decade later, UCI has become and continues to be a catalyst of change, progress, and innovation. I am so appreciative to have been a part of the FEMBA program, or as our class likes to say, FAMBA, because as cheesy as it sounds, through all the late night study groups, those tasty ABP meals before class, and traveling together to different countries, we truly have become more like family than classmates. Together, most of us have learned how to function with very little sleep and relied heavily on caffeinated and other beverages to get through these long days and nights. After we leave here, we may not remember exactly what was taught that second week of finance or that fourth P of marketing, but undoubtedly, we will never forget the moments shared with those we were able to engage and build relationships with. Most people enter business school with the hopes of career growth in order to attain financial success. I want to emphasize that every one of us is capable of making more money. However, none of us can manufacture more time. So while we think about making money, we should also think about making meaning, because we're absolutely capable of both. Because of the relationships we've made, whether or not we leave here with a firm grasp of what our future entails, as long as we seek meaning, focus on our dreams, and begin to live them today, not someday, the future will be an unquestionably beautiful place. It won't happen all at once, so I want to leave you with the words that my grandmother ingrained in me: every day, chip away. Thank you, and congratulations, class of 2017.
There we go. Shannon, that was great. Wish you personal and professional success as well. Those are just a couple of the students. The competition was tough this year, as it always is, and it's been great just to hear from many of you as we've celebrated the last several weeks. As we meet today to celebrate the accomplishments of the class of 2017, we also want to honor our award recipients and ask that each graduate stand and remain standing to be recognized as his or her name is read. You'll also, these are also all in your program, okay? So hang on to those if you want later. You can go around and collect the autographs of these folks when you see them going out for the folk. You are a tough crowd, I'm telling you. Okay. All right, no. But actually, it's kind of fun. It is kind of fun to get some of these for yourself, for your friends. The Joe McGuire Award for the highest GPA in the MBA program is awarded to James Doxey. James, please stand. The George W. Brown Award for overall academic excellence and exceptional service to the Paul Mirage School of Business in the MBA Award is awarded to Christian Kelly Johnson. Christian, please stand. Remain standing. Let's remain standing. Stay up, folks. Paul and Lily Mirage Visionary Award goes to Brian Gallagher. Brian, please stand. The highest GPA in the executive MBA program is awarded to four. It's a four-way tie. I saw this the other night, and it's great. Daniel Emmons, Clayton James Haynes, Wei-Jean Liu, and Axel Axel's over here. I saw him earlier. Okay. The highest GPA in the healthcare executive MBA program is awarded to Dr. Israel Villanueva, Jr. And Dr. Israel, there he is. The highest GPA in the fully employed MBA program is awarded to Kate Cheng. It's a three-way tie. Muhammad Zubair Nawaz and Madhavan Subramanian Sankara. Madhavan. The highest GPA in the Masters of Professional Accountancy is also a four-way tie. We have a lot of programs with a lot of high achievers, don't we? Jeffrey Chiang, Avery French, Shangwei Viola Gong, and Shazon Lexi Liu. Please stand. I'm also proud to acknowledge our Bachelor of Arts Award recipients today. The Chancellor's Award of Distinction is presented in collaboration with the UC Irvine Alumni Association to these graduating seniors who represent exceptional academic achievement and a commitment to cutting-edge research, leadership, and service to UC Irvine. This distinction is awarded to two people, Arden Davis, we heard from earlier. Arden, please stand. And Michael Ho. Michael, please stand. Named for our former dean here today, the Andrew J. Policano Award is presented to the graduate who best represents the ideals of the Mirage School as demonstrated by both academic performance and contributions to the Mirage School community. Receiving this award is, he's already standing, Michael Ho. And graduating summa cum laude in the Bachelor of Arts program are, she's already standing, Arden Davis, and Jeff Jinglu Huang. Jeff. Congratulations. Let's congratulate all of these award winners and outstanding scholars. Go ahead and be seated. I would also like to thank all the students who gave of their time and talents in service to their fellow students and to the Mirage School. If you served as an officer of a student association, a club, or a class representative, will you please stand? All right. Thank you very much. Let's say thank you to them. All right, go ahead. As you notice, there's a lot of people standing. That's because it takes a lot of activity and a lot of leadership. So thank you for your leadership in that regard. Okay, it's now time to recognize our graduating students. I know that's what you've been waiting for, all right? It's great what we've so far what we've done, but now this is the time where we're going to each get you to have you come across the stage at some point here this morning. The Paul Mirage School of Business awards four degrees, the PhD, the Master of Business Administration, the Master of Professional Accountancy, and the Bachelor of Arts. Will the candidates for the degree of Doctor of Philosophy in Management please rise and remain standing? No, not yet. Okay, Chancellor Gilman, I'm pleased to present the candidates for the degree of Doctor of Philosophy in Management.
With the authority vested in me by the Regents of the University of California, I confer upon you the degree for which you have been recommended by your faculty, admitting you to all of the rights, privileges, and responsibilities which pertain to this degree, in testimony whereof, you will receive a diploma of the university. Congratulations. Dean Spangenberg, let's you and I congratulate the recipients. New doctorates, please come forward to be recognized. Associate Dean Terry Shivlin will read the names of these new doctors, their dissertations, chairs, and the faculty members who will hood them.
Good morning. As Associate Dean for Research and Doctoral Programs at the Merage School, I am both pleased and honoured to present these graduates of our PhD program. Just a little background on our PhD. These students were admitted to Merage from an applicant pool of over 300 individuals for 6 to 10 slots, so very competitive entry. The PhD involves 2 years of intensive graduate level study, a major field exam, then another 2 to 4 years identifying and working on their dissertation, plus working on joint research with faculty and other students. Thus, it takes a total of 5 to 6 years to earn their PhD. The students work closely with their thesis advisor and other faculty in completing their dissertation. These graduates now join the faculty at schools around the world to teach and conduct research. This year we have 8 graduates, with 6 of them being here today. The others have already left campus to take up faculty positions. Our first graduate is Ran Zhang. The thesis title was The Impact of Pricing and Targeting Strategy on Consumer Choice. His advisor is Professor V.C. Chowdhury, and will be hooded by V.C. Our second graduate is Chi Quan Wang, thesis title, Social Interaction and Market Reaction to Earnings News. His thesis advisor was Professor David Hirschleifer, who was not here today. So Chi Quan will be hooded by Professor Zheng Sun. Who are you? Who are you? Our next graduate is Yujin Li. Thesis title, The Impact of Hedging and Non-Hedging Derivatives on Tax Avoidance. Her advisor was me, Terry Shevlin, and I'll hood Yujin. Our next graduate is Yifan Li. Her thesis title was Limited Attention Bias in Intra-Industry Information Transfers, Evidence from Multi-Industry Segment News. Her thesis advisor was Professor Su Hong Teo. Su Hong is not here, and so I'll be hooding Yifan. Our next graduate is Jiharu Bai. Her thesis title is Interdisciplinary Research in Operations Management, Applications in Healthcare, Retailing, and On-Demand Service Platforms. Her co-advisors were Professors Robin Keller and Shia Yin. She'll be hooded by Professor Robin Keller. Congratulations. And our final and last but not least graduate is Sora Kim. Thesis title, Follow Me on Twitter, Attracting Mutual Funder Investor Attention Through Social Media. Her thesis advisor, Professor Zhang Sun. That concludes the presentation of doctoral degrees. I wish to congratulate and offer my best wishes to all graduates of the Merage School this year. Thank you.
The Paul Merage School of Business grants one MBA degree, but through four different programs, enabling our students to choose the delivery and specialized topics that best suit their interests. The full-time MBA, the executive MBA, the healthcare executive MBA, and the fully employed MBA. Before calling each group up separately at this time, I would like to ask all the candidates for the degree of Master's in Business Administration to please rise and remain standing. Chancellor Gilman, it is my pleasure to present to you the candidates for the degree of Master of Business Administration.
With the authority vested in me by the Regents of the University of California, I confer upon you the degree for which you have been recommended by your faculty, admitting you to all of the rights, privileges, and responsibilities which pertain to that degree, in testimony whereof you will receive a diploma of the university. Congratulations. Dean Spangenberg and an Associate Dean O'Quizen, please come forward to congratulate the recipients.
So I would like to invite the full-time MBAs to please come forward. I'm going to ask that you please hold your applause until all of the candidates from each program have come across the stage.
James Doxey.
Hillis Kirsten.
Scott Zoltan.
Edmund Goodhue Montanari.
William Krieger.
Gavin Foster.
Joshua Burke.
Peter Lynn.
Paul Nichols.
Ryan Platt.
Yeji Lee.
Bradley West.
Tuvu.
Richard Rule.
Justin Latino.
John Saraku.
Shiming Chai.
Helia Diabeji.
Jared Farkas.
Layli Sharifzadeh.
Brian Gallagher.
Vanessa Mora.
Jerry Chen.
Pulkit Sindwani.
Christian Johnson.
Wainu Gatika.
Jenna Dover.
Jason Chevalier.
Melanie Henderson.
Raul Sanjnani.
Shalom Sunny.
Bruno Rocha de Toledo.
Clarissa Coultas.
Kenny Tran.
Anna George.
Christine Yang. David Maimon.
Christine Yang.
Laura Wang.
Robbie Indato.
Yunyun Rowe.
David Castaneda Gorostidi.
Chenki Yu.
RJ D. Cruz.
Bina Baska.
Ashish Yadav.
Jennifer Chin.
Tsuyoshi Nojima.
Aiden Wallace.
Abhinav Natarajan.
Hung No.
Priya Ramaratnam.
Vabi Grover.
Vijay Gary Shankar.
Leon Krasnov.
Prubhat Tripathi.
Yuichi Yokoi.
Cheong Wu.
Shashank Ganesh Malia.
Congratulations.
Chamandeep Singh. Praveen Shatila Surana.
Yong Sung Cho.
Ankur Mighty.
Junsu Kim.
Karthik Mukamala.
Jihoon Yu.
Sudeep Sahu.
Youngwoon Lee.
Shankamala Chowdhury.
Jongyuk Seo.
Ahmed Tanvir.
William Zhao. Akiko Niwa. Sungmin Choi. Sunho Ryu.
Oh, I'm sorry. I guess our MBA students, please go ahead and sit down. We will be calling each one of the programs up individually. Sorry about that. A little bit. Slight issue. In the meantime, let me go ahead and invite up our executive MBA candidates to please come forward.
Weijin Liu.
Axel Rademacher.
Clayton Haynes.
Daniel Emmons.
Elizabeth Arroyo Morgan.
Edward Zepfel.
Stephanie Klein.
Tina Fay.
Valerie Hoff.
Rajshri Shyam.
Carolyn Castillo.
Miwako Mekubo.
Kirsty Damoto.
Jesse Olitokit.
Joanna Faulkner.
Vince Jafari.
James Hoppy.
Andrew Briggs.
Janelle Brunette.
John Camus.
Abdiel Maldonado.
David Kang.
Sally Lamb.
Breshan Maguire.
Abbas Megji.
Vaughn Chase.
Juan Hodiji.
Kupil Chaudhry.
Vikram Shemkalyani. Kunal Grover.
Srinivas Linjineni.
Wayne Rapp. Waleed Mohammed Mahmoud.
I would like to now invite the healthcare executive MBAs to please come forward.
Dr. Israel Villanueva.
Carlos Guerra.
Vicky Magana Medina.
Stephanie Medina Benson.
Cole Cameron.
Rachel Hogue.
Sunny Shen.
David Keanu.
Joy Davis Burke.
Sharuk Shahani.
John Paul Rule.
Jamie Vera Montez.
Mirnaz Masumi.
Brandy Arthur.
Jeff Kohlberg.
Thank you.
Aaron Reyes.
Judy John Egan White.
Dr. Clinton Kakazu.
Jeffrey Johnson.
Rajagopalan Venkatarumani.
Daniel Sun. Wes Adams.
And now I would like to invite our fully employed MBAs to please come forward.
Jason Zaraga.
Shifa Nazumuddin.
Pooja Raja.
Sherry Kerico.
Shannon Shetty.
Jeff Reffert Forneth.
Mahadevan Shankar.
Andrew Wan.
Maliha Siddiqui.
Darren Endo.
Kelly Jae Ling.
Dewey Pham.
Van Nago.
Nick Peng.
Hersha Devjani.
Alan So.
Gaurav Sharma.
Michael Herron.
Mohammed Nobar.
Alexandra Alcon.
Shalane Patel.
Effie Melos.
Sarkis Daglian.
Edward Vidal.
Andrew Grimm.
Andrew Williams.
Cindy Kua.
Maxim Babui.
Christopher Ambrosini.
Jeffrey Fong.
Katie Nicole Nyberg.
James Ryan Shelton Hall.
Sinue Brito Aguirre.
Brianne Nicole Davis.
Mohit Anand.
Jeffrey Fry.
Ebony Winston.
Andrade.
Kai Chen.
Christian Andrade.
Nathan Shapiro.
Patrick Ma.
Jennifer L. Wood.
Elias Miguel Angulo.
May Hout.
Nathan Semper.
Vivian Ang.
Jennifer Comstock.
Adrian Merler.
Omar Ali.
Scott Winter.
Benjamin Palmer.
Bernice Cheng.
Serene Prouty.
Julian Jacobi.
Adrian Saintsier.
Simon Liu.
Karen Kwan.
Alessandro Bassi.
Doris Kim Ming Do.
Christine Hiraya Mata.
Irina Marinescu.
Arturo Enrico Montoya.
Grace Kim.
Brianne Nicole Penna.
Trevor Gomes.
Jacob DiCiocio.
Mike Seropian.
Zubair Nawaz.
William S. Story.
Jose Lee.
Siegfried Wolf.
Pooja Parik Patel.
Tony Velardez.
Casey Foster.
Ash Desai.
Minyue Zhao.
Jay Lee.
Elaine Yang Wing.
Brian James Sandor.
Felicia Fierro.
Alan Lane Chan.
Rosemary Poor.
Ellie Abassi.
Kunal Sachdeva.
Rina Chelani Carr.
Garrett Lynch.
Jennifer Aldor.
Matthew Chang.
Andrea Duarte.
Brian Rogness.
Tammy Liu.
Wissam Shayeb.
Rosalie Chi.
Josh Hillman.
Michael Doe.
Lauren Caldwell Shatterley Gully.
Derek Lee.
Christine Dardant.
Jeff Bowie.
Claire Buto.
Kevin Stout.
Stephen Liang.
Jared Burke.
Johnson Tu.
Tornambe.
Dominic Tornambe.
Michael O.
Kiwan Park.
Abraham Luera.
Paul Lillis.
Alejandro Garcia.
John Sprague.
Karthik Dandigala.
George Chen.
John Allen.
Stephen Boyd.
Kurt Smetana.
Roberto Carlos Reza.
Okay, congratulations to the MBAs, huh? That's great. All right, this is just the fourth year that the Paul Merage School of Business has granted a Master's of Professional Accountancy. And I'd like to ask that all the candidates for the degree of Master's of Professional Accountancy please rise and remain standing. Chancellor Gilman, I am pleased to present to you the candidates for the degree in the Master's of Professional Accountancy.
With the authority vested in me by the Regents of the University of California, I confer upon you the degree for which you have been recommended by your faculty, admitting you to all of the rights, privileges, and responsibilities which pertain to that degree, in testimony whereof you will receive a diploma of the university. Congratulations. Dean Spangenberg and MPAC Program Director Patricia Wellmeyer, please come forward to congratulate the recipients.
I would like to now invite the Masters of Professional Accountancy graduates to please come forward.
Yeah. Jeffrey Chiang.
Avery Lynn Victoria French.
Lu Yu Erwan.
Alyssa Williams.
Shushin Han.
Alexis Nichelle Baxter.
Viola Gong.
Janice Song.
Kathleen Tsu.
Felix Marisol.
Ruhan Dunn.
Sana Salim.
Yimin Wang.
Savannah King.
Eileen Shu.
Xiaotong Lu.
Allison Hong.
Jennifer Fan.
Li Bin Pun.
Summer Hill.
Ji Jen Shu.
Christina Puchko.
Wu Jian Hu.
Connie Chen.
Kevin Singh.
Wanming Priscilla Zin.
Li Meng Ma.
Tony Wang.
Xin Xin Ge.
Daniel Rosano.
Wen Li Yang.
Trevor Boswell.
Wu Yin.
Chuhang Chang.
Yan Kui.
Tyron Fang.
Bo Yuan Chen.
Ron Wang.
Ji Wan Chang.
Shizan Liu.
Tian Yu Tia.
Yi Lim.
Xin Shan Chen.
Daniel Kubov.
Katrina Tsai.
Esther Zhang.
Jia Chung De.
Yunhua Jun.
Queen Ma.
Matthew Petrella.
Xia Han Li.
Luke Hatch.
Kei Chen Shi.
Michael Maori.
Yilin Chu.
Roy J. Bagon.
Chuan Tian Chao.
Simon Vakili.
Yuan Yuan Chao.
Chung Nguyen.
Rui Han Li.
Yutaka Fujimoto.
Pearl Lian.
Joe Wan.
Susan Zeng.
Rejun Tian.
Se Young Park.
Yu Teng.
Moon Nam Cho.
Wen Wen Chan.
Will Chang.
Zhuhong Tang.
Zian Ji.
Chaolang Chen.
Lu Chi.
Manhan Wu.
Yue Yao.
Yonghan Wei.
Li Li.
Jiejie Huang.
Bi He Bella Du.
Megan Liu.
Yanan Ivy Zhou.
Tianying Wang.
Jasper Su.
Let's go, Jasper!
Chenlu Shao.
Sean Kanwun Cho.
Judy Tan.
Amanda Udit Sin.
Jeshi Chen.
Kathy Chung.
Danny Tan.
Meiting Elisa Huang.
Shutian Luo.
Emily Yang.
Tongying Shen.
Candice Yip. Yimei Chen. Yi Liu. Jin Zhe Zhang. Ting Che Cheng.
Okay, this year, well, first, let's just say one last congratulations to the Masters of Professional Accountancy. All right, so this year, the Paul Merage School of Business is proud to be graduating the Bachelor of Arts in Business Administration to, not graduating, granting the Bachelor of Arts in Business Administration to 160 senior undergraduates. I would like to ask that all the candidates for the Bachelor of Arts in Business Administration please rise and remain standing. Chancellor Gilman, I am pleased to present the candidates for the degree of Bachelor of Arts in Business Administration.
With the authority vested in me by the Regents of the University of California, I confer upon you the degree for which you have been recommended by your faculty, admitting you to all of the rights, privileges, and responsibilities which pertain to this degree. In testimony whereof, you will receive a diploma of the university. Congratulations. And now, new bachelors, I invite you to take part in a time-honored academic tradition. Since the days long ago when students were first identified by the caps and gowns they wore, those who had not yet earned a degree wore the tassel on the right side of the mortarboard. When the degree was conferred, the scholar moved the tassel to the left and joined a select company. So now, following that academic tradition and in recognition of your new status, bachelors, turn your tassels. Nicely done. Dean Spangenberg and Associate Dean V.C. Chowdhury, please come forward to congratulate the recipients.
I would like to now invite the Bachelor of Arts in Business Administration graduates to please come forward.
Arden Davis.
Connie Yang.
Jeff Huang.
Fernanda Rodriguez.
Peter Van Voys.
Nicole Amaro.
Jordan Galen.
Sarah Lynn.
Jean Humphreys.
Christine Vumai.
Cruz Aguilar.
Jack Yu.
Parmeet Chadha.
Chris Wu.
Chu.
Hong Zhao.
Kakit Yu.
Cyrus Tukzada.
Yanyi Ho.
Madhav Hans.
Yingzhu Chen.
Roshni Patel.
Akiko Watanabe.
Vicky Fan. Kilyi Huan.
John Lopez.
Celine Xiao Tzu.
Yvonne Lee.
Tiffany Luhan.
Esperanza Botteo.
Gabriel Hussein Kenan.
Adrian Chu.
Audrey Chia.
Dana Wu.
Ernesto Miguel.
Janet Romo.
Darlena Fan.
Payal Patel.
Dennis Huynh.
Fiona Young.
Ni Pham.
Ye Yao.
Brandon Lopez Villegas.
Xiaochan Chen.
Ariel Chang.
Xiaoyan Liu.
Kevin Cabarreo.
Kanglei Wang.
Michael Bryan.
Peng Wong.
Nupa Gosalia.
Li Zeng.
Jessica Huang.
Chenqing Song.
Maggie Tsui.
Tianyi Sha.
Anita So.
Chao Zhuang Chen.
Sehan Kim.
Yibo Zhou.
Angelo Guo.
Nancy Guo.
Siping Chen.
Yayu Luo.
Lianqin Li.
Tanlung Wu.
Haorong Shi.
Siyu Zhao.
Yasenia Perez Benitez.
Rainy Ma.
Sandy Tzu Wei.
Dongshu Cheng.
Michael Grego.
Dandan Chow.
Own Ayub.
Chenlu Wong.
Jiho John Kim.
Victoria Su.
Tyler Vu. Xian Xu Su.
Han Zheng.
Connie Wong.
Kristen Nguyen.
Irene Sora Kang.
Allison Klaas.
Ida Oyuki Avalos.
Ryan Chu.
Christy Tanubrata.
Anthony Galicia.
Anthony Ankawijawa.
Lauren Kung.
Winnie Angeline.
Alex Wu.
Ingrid Amelia.
Suraj Kirona.
Cerise Hong.
Shooting Tan.
Huang. Jessica Huang.
Hawaii Wong.
Yichun Huang.
Menki Lee.
Bowan Leo.
Huimin Hu.
Linda Tang.
Gaojin Zeng.
Joy Chen. Rebecca Tian.
Madeline Clark.
Dina Nguyen.
Annie Wong.
Emily Liu.
Yubin Lee.
Jennifer Sun.
Tiffany Bui.
Sharon Huang.
Joshua Fukugawa.
Vivian Mai.
Jenny Kim.
Aaron Matsumoto.
Katie Lavelle.
Michael Ho.
Ryan Mayfield.
Eileen Ju.
Ian Shropshire.
Jackie Sue.
Kelly Miranda.
Austin Lamb.
Nicolette Dietrich.
Yu Chao He.
Hannah Thrash.
Shannon Valerie Lee.
Becky Lee.
Christine Pham.
Nicole Williams.
Ellen Ha.
Raquel Ann Uwe.
Ni Jang.
Heather Lee.
Jenny Wu.
Jennifer Tran.
Shirley Liang.
Elizabeth Krause.
Jason Ibarra.
Merudi Mahasiri.
Jeffrey Bowie.
Tiffany Husanali.
Ukiho Ogawa.
Sabrina Yunus.
Albert Tao.
Yui Chao.
Jenny Nguyen.
Is that it?
Lindsay Tran. Yixuan Chu.
All right. Okay, so let's just say one more time then congratulations to our undergraduate class of 2017. And let's give a hand to Mr. Kiki here, who handed you the lapel pins, the mace bearer, and representing the alumni here.
Yeah.
And he shook twice as many hands as I did, because he got both sides. So good work, Mark. There are some very special guests here today. We're just about done, I promise. But I want to say that we have to ask the graduates. I want you to say thank you to those that have encouraged you, in many cases made great sacrifices so that you could be here today. We've talked about that a couple of times, but I want to specifically give a moment here for you to say thank you to the parents, spouses, significant others, grandparents, children, friends, all the loved ones and supporters of the graduates. Please stand up for a round of applause. So I know that there's a lot of celebration to come, so I don't want to take too much more of your time. I just want to say that I will add my personal congratulations to the class of 2017 in just a moment, but we have to do one more thing, and we have a tradition here that I didn't realize until the first time I did this how great and silly it is all at the same time. You got to stand up now, and you're going to join me in the raising your hands and throwing out three strong anteaters zots, all right? Remember how we do this, right? Okay. So on three. One, two, three. Zot, zot, zot. Nice job. All right. So you might want to take a seat because the commencement ceremony is done, but we're going to conclude it with the recessional march. And I'm going to ask that the audience remain seated until the recessional is completed. So thanks to all of you for participating in today's ceremony. Look forward to seeing you. Look in your diploma holder. There's some rules in there, some suggestions, and one of those is visit often. And I'll just let you take a look at the rest of them. But that we didn't want it to just be an empty one until the diploma came in the mail. So I look forward to many of you joining us. You're all welcome to come over to the Merage School buildings and the courtyard. And we've got light refreshments. And you can take more pictures and show folks who might not have seen where you went to school the buildings and so forth. But with that, I will ask the recessional music to begin. And our mace marshal will lead us out. Thank you very much, everyone. Congratulations.